Hi girl, I lah yang call you. So, rumah ni kena jual.
Oh, sorry, I don't get your name. Lupa nama you.
They call me Jamil.
Si?
Nico.
Nico, nama betul you?
Fatima.
Oh, okay. Saya Kak Ambul Cusa Maran, 22 tahun sebagai ijah hartanah, banyak mendalikan dan menyelesaikan kes rumit. Kes Farahid, kes upgrade downgrade, Club 55 dan berbagai lagi. Hubungi saya di 9235 sifar sifar 2 sifar atau ikuti saya di media sosial sebelum masalah semakin rumit. So apa masalah yang hari ni yang Kak Cusa datang, you were telling me that about your mother house, about your own shelter, apa sebenarnya masalah?
Mak, can I talk?
Perempuan lah leceh dia ni.
Okay. Parents kita dah meninggal.
Okay.
Okay, sekarang, I'm not 35 yet.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. She is, I'm just 31
years okay.
old.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Masalahnya, kita nak kena jual di rumah.
Okay.
Okay. But we cannot.
Okay.
Okay, because saya banyak hutang.
Alright, alright.
Okay, I got a lot of hutang, whatever, but my share is still more than you.
Alright.
Alah, apa leceh sangat? Arwah mak tu tinggalkan rumah ni untuk kita duduk tunggu sampai salah satu kahwin. Bukan macam dah nak kahwin je, lepas tu alah macam
ni. Tak, kenapa you ada banyak hutang? What makes you banyak hutang?
Adalah sebab-sebab tertentu.
Ah, mengkeledekkan diri mestilah.
Yeah, you jangan masuk campur lah pasal ni hal, okey? Awak tu dah macam nak step jantan dekat sini, dah perempuan nak feeling-feeling lelaki, you nak blame saya pula.
Dari
please
kau?
Girl, please.
Asyik ambil hormon je, masih sama
aku ambil hormon tak pakai duit kau apa?
Oh, so because of hormon, itu yang banyak hutang?
Memanglah. Okay. Saya, I have to admit that.
Okay.
Thanks, pecahkan lubang.
Okay, so the thing is, okay, look here. This house basically is your parents' house, betul?
Yes,
okay. So you nak menjual and you all want to buy your own separate house, betul?
Yeah.
Alright? You okay?
I actually tak kisah pun. Cuma macam kan since rumah dah bayar, dah duduk sini senang-senang lagi nak pergi bayar-bayar.
Okay, let me explain to you. This house doesn't belong to the both of you, okay?
No, it's our parents.
Yes. Yeah. So in the flat details, I tengok it's under your mom's name. Because your dad already passed away.
Yeah.
And now it's your mom's name. Mm-hmm. So it's under the estate. Have you all done your administrator yet?
Haven't. Saya tak tahu apa nak buat pun actually. Kita just nak run through how can we sell the house.
Okay.
Yeah, but so, like I said, you know, umur berpasal.
Okay.
And hutang.
Alright, okay. Hutang, you hutang kan bukan dia kan?
Saya yang hutang.
Okay. So, first of all, we need to engage a lawyer to do the administrator for your parents' place. Your mum lah.
Okay.
Your mum house. So, from there, and then after the administrator dah buat, then we have to do the indemnity of the HDB. Okay? Which is basically, you need to put your name into the house and then baru boleh jual. Okay? So, the thing is, who want to be the administrator?
Can I, walaupun umur 31 years old?
It's okay. As long as you're 21 and above, okay, you can be the administrator of the flat. Dia macam gini, administrator or co-administrator. Kalau you tak percaya dengan your brother, you can be the co-administrator takut duit hilang ke apa ke. You know, I'm being very open. Okay? Mm-hmm. It means that both of you can be the administrator and co-administrator. Apa-apa mengenai rumah, both of you have to sign. So, which one you want?
Pasal I tengok macam you tak kisah, so I will be the one lah.
So, macam mana?
Dia tanya, dia jawab sendiri, rantak lah.
So, he is the only one, eh? So, you be the administrator and of course, basically, based on Farahid, you got 2 shares, you got 1 shares. Okay? We settle the house first. Okay? We settle
whatever
the house first.
Whatever.
Okay, we settle the house first. And then, once transmission of death semua dah settle, the name will be your name as the administrator. Lepas tu, baru boleh fikirkan untuk menjual rumah. From there, and then, yourself have to apply HDB. You dah boleh apply pasal you dah above 35. So, we can see how much loan you can get. Maybe kalau misal kata your loan semua dah cukup, everything cukup, maybe you can beli dulu. Okay, for him, you pun boleh beli sebab you are above 21 and you anak yatim piatu. If you anak yatim sahaja, you cannot buy. You have to wait for 35. Okay. Get it?
See, I told you, boleh selesai apa ni masalah. Yang you ni nak ini hege-hege semua apa, kita kena jual ni rumah. Ni rumah bukan under kita, you tahu tak? We have.
Yeah.
So that is why I call Kak Amboi datang sini. So, you shut it, girl.
Limas lah. Settle lah dia ni.
Okay. So, the thing is, we settle one thing at a time. We settle the administrator. And then once settle, and then after we got all the documents, you can apply your HLE. For you, you also can apply your HLE. Tetapi, you tak dapat grant. Because you are not 35. She will get the housing grant. Are you okay with that?
Yeah.
Ngada. That's fine.
Okay. Eh, aku mengada-ngada. Aku yang tak dapat grant, susahkan kau. Letak kan?
Kau babikkan aku sebab aku nak duduk rumah ni.
Tak boleh, sis.
At the end of the day, you are still my sister, okay?
Dah, eh? If let's say another way, kalau misal kata both of you can work hand in hand, gini dah gaduh, you can actually combine and buy another flat, a bigger flat if
ya
you like.
Ya ampun, tak kisahlah. Apa yang tak kisah? Aku kisah. Aku tak kuasa tengok muka ni dengan mulut puaka macam gini.
I'm not asking you to be with me 24/7. You can do your hal in your room and I do mine in my room.
Kurimas dengan kau.
Tapi kahwin lah sebenarnya.
Aku nak tumbuk. Okay.
Dah. Okay. Dah. So that is another alternative. Kalau misal kata you want to buy separate, you can buy separate. Or else you can combine and buy a bigger flat. You that one you can consider first. That one you can consider. The most important thing is what you want and what do you want in life. This is what I always tell my client. I got one customer pun macam you all juga. Adik-beradik. Tapi dia orang empat adik-beradik. Diorang pun bergaduh. Stay one roof. No matter what, rumah HDB have to sell. Walaupun you're the administrator, you still... Are you okay? Are you sweating?
Yeah, I'm sweating.
You okay?
I nervous. I macam rimas sekejap panas.
Pasal and am I garang sangat ke? Buat-buat tak?
Okay. Okay.
You're okay? I'm okay?
Yeah.
I yang rimas.
So the thing is, one case study yang Kak Susan pernah buat is empat adik-beradik. No matter what, HDB mesti nak kena dijual. Walaupun you're the administrator, you can still stay on to the house. Tetapi whatever rebates tak dapat lah. You can stay on. If let's say you do not want to sell also, it's up to you. Because if you want to lantik dia sebagai administrator, you have to sign and lawyer offices.
Takpe lah, you settle lah.
So you see, I told you she don't care.
Okay, so the thing is, we settle one thing at a time, we settle the lawyer thing first, and then after that we settle the HDB, we start to sell. Meantime, both of you apply HLE dulu. Then, your HLE loan dah keluar, kita jumpa lagi, kita buat pengiran. That's the most important thing. Jangan nanti dah jual rumah, tak ada tempat tinggal. Itulah satu lagi satu case. Adik-beradik bertekak pasal rumah ada masalah. Masalah faraid. Dan diorang pula dia jadi anak yatim piatu. Bukan anak yatim . Kalau jadi piatu, above 21 baru boleh beli rumah sendiri. Tetapi tak dapat grant. Apa-apa pun, check dengan HDB on your loan dengan your eligibility on your grant. Itu yang paling important, guys. Kes macam gini, saya dah banyak mengendalikan masalah-masalah macam gini. Kalau korang ada masalah macam gini, jangan lupa PM ke DM Kak Abu Susan Mariam di Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, Twitter atau di Google aja Kak Abu Susan Mariam. Sebab saya ni agak rajin update policy-policy, buat live. Kadang-kadang you all boleh ask me question during my live dan sebagainya. Maybe suara saya ni macam garang, tapi saya tak garang. Nak menyelesaikan masalah, orang kat luar sana tengok daripada kes. Ada kes susah, ada kes senang. Akan tetapi permulaan kita berjumpa, konsultasi saya percuma. Dari situ kita berunding, komisen saya macam mana, berapa, apa-apa pun komisen saya semua negotiable. Semua akan berunding dan anda akan sign dengan saya. Apabila awak setujulah. Lagi satu, kalau korang nak tahu kes-kes macam-macam kes lah. Kes macam korang ke, apa-apa kes lah dekat YouTube saya. You jangan lupa subscribe saya punya YouTube. Jangan lupa call saya 9235-0020. Selamat ada Kak Abu Susan Mariam. Saya Kak Abu Susan Mariam, 22 tahun sebagai ejen hartanah, banyak mengendalikan dan menyelesaikan kes rumit. Khususnya kes cerai, kes rumah nak tarik, banyak hutang melibatkan hartanah. Hubungi saya di 9235-0020 atau ikuti saya di media sosial sebelum masalah semakin rumit.